98.7 FM and 98.7FM.com. It's Darren Rose joining me on the phone right now, frontman for the band AFI, Davey Havoc. You guys are in town for Bamboozle next week. You played it a couple years ago on the East Coast. How are the East Coast fans different than the West Coast fans?
They seem to be very, very dedicated to us and very into what we do. So that's something that really is a common thread between all fans everywhere. We tend to have more fans closer to the coast, you know, whether it be in you know, Los Angeles or New York City. So in those places, we get large groups of these very passionate fans. So it's great.
Right. And obviously, your origins start here in California.
Yeah.
And, you know, a lot of people may not know that AFI's, you guys have been around for 18 years. I mean, you're going on two decades now.
Yeah, it's true. I think, next summer will be 20 years. This summer will be 19.
Yeah, and people have pretty much watched you grow up. That's
that's
cool.
Very true.
Yeah. Now, people that haven't seen an AFI show, how would you describe to someone who's never been, maybe they're going to Bamboozle next week on the 27th at Anaheim Stadium, how would you define a show?
It's a very high-energy show. We are very passionate about what we do, and on stage, we very much react to the music that we're playing. And in the same respect, the crowd does as well. So there's a large exchange of energy between us and the crowd, you know, generally speaking, and a lot of singing along from the crowd, which is really nice. It's a great feeling to be out there and, you know, hear hundreds or thousands of people singing the words as loud as they can and overwhelming the speakers. It's pretty great.
Yeah, and I mean, you know, AFI has, I think, one of the most passionate fan followings of any modern band right now. It's amazing to see those shows. You're right. The energy is just electric.
Thank you.
Yeah. Do you have I know it's probably tough to pick favorites, but do you have a venue or a city or state that you just can't wait to come and play every year?
Well, I mean, to be honest, you know, Los Angeles is our strongest. You know, those are typically the best shows is when we play in Southern California. So, you know, whether it's Hollywood or Orange County or San Diego, we always have just generally speaking great shows in Southern California.
Well, we can't wait for the show coming up. What are the summer plans? I heard it just came through. AFI opening this summer for Green Day.
Yes, I'm very excited about that.
Dude, how did that all come about?
Well, we've been friends with the Green Day guys for quite some time, and we've been fans of Green Day for even longer. We used to go see them at parties and, you know, little tiny venues and vets halls and stuff like that in the early 90s. And in the middle of this tour, Billy wrote me an email and asked what we were doing in the summer, and I said, we're just hanging out. And he said, do you want to come on tour? And I said, absolutely. And it went on from there, and now we're doing it.
That's great. It's like a couple of guys going to hang out. What are you doing this weekend? You
know? Yeah, totally.
That's great.
You know, so I mean, we are thrilled about it. I mean, Green Day is one of the tightest, most powerful bands that is playing today, and it's, you know, so exciting to be able to tour with them after all these years of being fans. Actually, AFI has only played, I think, once or twice with Green Day in festival circumstances. So this will be the first time that we actually play on a proper Green Day show, and we get to play on, you know, a whole month of them.
Yeah, that's going to be an amazing bill for
I'm
sure.
Excited.
Do you know if it's coming through SoCal?
I believe it is.
Woo!
I believe it is, yeah.
Good stuff.
I think I saw that on the routing.
Good stuff. Hey, I want to go back to the beginning with you, with AFI kicking off, you know, obviously originating in high school, putting those everything together. When did you know? When did Davey Havoc know that this is what I want to do? I want to be a musician. I want to be an artist. This is what I want my lifetime to be. Was there a moment or an event that happened?
I mean, in a sense, certainly it was something that I always wanted to do, but I didn't really have the courage to dedicate myself to the life because I knew that, you know, to dedicate myself to what we were doing was to really make the decision that I was going to be, you know, separate from any sort of normalcy, any sort of regular life. You know, it meant I never was going to have a home. It meant I was never going to, you know, be in one place long enough to establish, you know, normal, quote-unquote, relationships with friends and so on and so forth, and, you know, freak out my parents, you know, things like that, if the, you know, when we're talking about being a teenager. And
That's impressive perspective for a teenager. I mean, to have, you know, because you automatically think at that age, I did anyway, that that's the most glamorous lifestyle ever. There's only upsides. And it sounds like you knew right away. I mean, you know, you're exactly right. You don't really have a home. You're constantly on the go.
Yeah. Well, I mean, we were playing hardcore.
Yeah.
You know, we weren't doing something that we thought we ever could have any sort of commercial success with. We mm-hmm. never wanted it. We never thought we could. It wasn't really part of our consciousness at all. So that clarity was easier to come by because we weren't thinking, we're going to do this and, you know, we're going to get on MTV and we're going to get on Warped Tour, which didn't exist. We're going to get, you know, like mm-hmm. we're going to reach all these people. We thought, okay, well, we're going to do this and we're going to play what we love for the few people who care about what we do. And that's fine. And we made that decision after playing a reunion show in 1993, having broke up for about 6 months when we all left high school and moved to different cities. We played a reunion show at the Phoenix Theater in Petaluma, California. And about 200 people came to the show, and everyone was singing along, and it was the first time that had ever happened. And we went downstairs to the dressing room after the show, and the owner of the venue, as well as a couple of the members of Dead and Gone who played the show with us, were insisting that we couldn't break up, that we had to continue doing it, because that what we were doing was important. And we were so moved by their words in the show that we had just played that we all right then decided, yeah, absolutely, this is what's important. This is what we have to do for the rest of our lives. Let's do it.
That's right. Yeah, we're talking with Davey Havok of AFI. Album Crash Love is in stores now, playing Bamboozle in Anaheim Stadium next Saturday, March 27th. Davey, how, because for a lot of bands that start out hardcore, like you said, you didn't think of the mainstream commercial success at mm-hmm. that time.
Yeah.
Was that a welcome transition for you? Was that something you fought or debated out as a band?
Oh, no. I mean, by the time, you know, any of the greater public came to recognize us, we had been a band for 12 years, 13 mm-hmm. years. And so, you know, by the time that happened, we were no longer a punk rock hardcore band. And, you know, our music had just grown and progressed so much. And, you know, politically, it wasn't, you know, as I said, it was something that we were never interested in. But it wasn't anything that we decried. It was just something that wasn't part of our consciousness. It wasn't appropriate to think about for what we were doing. And when we reached the point that, you know, we outgrew the indies and our music kept growing and growing, and we wanted to reach more and more people. When we did so, it was just a joy. You know, it was just fantastic for us.
Yeah, and you guys, I mean, and that's like a huge compliment, I think, because a lot of bands don't make that transition well, and you guys did it and were able to, you know, keep the old fans and amass hundreds of thousands more. So that's,
yeah, we're definitely very, very lucky to do that. I you know, really do appreciate that, because as you said, it is a rarity.
Yeah. A couple more questions, Davey. There's an event that just kind of started out here in L.A. called the Sunset Strip Music Festival.
Mm-hmm, yeah, I've seen the billboards for it.
Yeah, yeah, and it was a huge success. We're, you know, it's going on again this year. We're the presenting sponsors of that event. And what we start to ask artists is, you know, obviously with, you know, the Sunset Strip being such a, like, iconic area for music and just so much history there. What are your early memories? Either maybe you went to a show early on as a kid, or you know, AFI's you know, time on the Sunset Strip. Do you have any particular memories of that?
Yeah, I mean, well, when I think of the Sunset Strip, I mean, my mind goes to the Doors playing at the Roxy, and then, you know, 20 years later, Motley Crue playing the Whiskey, and there were hardcore shows, you know, thereafter in the 90s that I would go see or play. You know, there was the big Straight Edge California Takeover show at the Whiskey, and we've been playing the Sunset Strip since the mid-90s. I don't know if we got down there in the early 90s, but the first mm-hmm. time we played in Hollywood was on the Strip, and it was at the Whiskey. And then we had a succession of shows at the Whiskey and at the Roxy. We played, you know, both of those venues many times. Gosh, I mean, I have tons of memories of the Sunset Strip. All positive.
Yeah, and now it sounds like you guys have played many of the venues. What show stands out the most for you?
We did a tour that we brought At the Drive-In with us. So we played at the Roxy with At the Drive-In, and we were huge fans of them. Just to let you know how long ago that was, we brought At the Drive-In with us.
That's
that was
great.
A good show.
Awesome. Again, talking to Davey Havok of AFI in town next week. Can't wait for Bamboozle, man. And obviously this summer with Green Day.
Yeah, thank you. I'm looking forward to it as well.
Thanks for checking in with us.
Sure.
Yeah, looking forward to having you guys come out, and appreciate your time.
All right, thank you very much.
Thanks, Dave. We'll talk soon.
Okay, bye.